So my dad and I are down here in the Coulee Bottoms. We're looking for there's a structure down here, some kind of, what did you call it? Some kind of art.
Some sort of art installation out of all the junk that they found in
the Coulee? Like, it looks like Fat Albert's junkyard, his clubhouse. But the city, a friend in this from the city sent me pictures of it in an email today because apparently they're going to rip it down as a dangerous structure. They wanted to know if I knew anything about it. I told them, nope, it's not mine. But yeah, it looks pretty fascinating. Like somebody put in a lot of work to build this thing. So we're going to come down here and see if we can get across onto the island and check it out. Beavers have constructed a natural bridge for us. Maybe. Yeah, it looks like a pretty good one there.
You go first.
Yeah. Those beavers know how to build. No worries.
There's another one up there.
Oh yeah. This'll work.
Yeah. This will be a good chance.
Don't fall through.
Well, it's pretty solid over here.
So. Yeah, it's nice and solid. You just gotta be willing to get your
toes
a little wet. All right, looks like we're coming up on it. Out here in the trees. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, you can get right up in here too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Man. Somebody put a lot of effort into this.
Yeah, they did. Yeah, so this is it. It's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, you should take them on a tour around this thing.
Yeah.
I can't believe that thing went to junk down here.
Yeah, somebody saved... You know, somebody went along the river and collected all the crap. All the flotsam car parts and bicycles and junk. Wired it all together.
Tons of wire.
Look at that. There's like beads and stuff in here. Rocks and feathers and bicycles and pipes, old stove ranges and bed frames, baby strollers, all kinds of stuff.
No panties.
No.
Wow. This monstrosity of all this junk that looks like it's stuff that could have been dredged from the riverside or in the river. And it's almost, I mean, there's a floor there and it's got walls around it. It's almost like a habitat. They've taken all the junk of society and created a environment to actually live in for some purpose, for, you know, camping out or...
Yeah, they could very easily, if they wanted to, they could have very easily added a roof to this with some
of
these pieces.
Maybe that's part of their plan. They might be planning on putting a roof over this thing.
Could be.
But what gets me is they used all this real bulky stuff, this huge stuff, and then they got all these little micro things that they added to it that they saw just as much value in the little ephemeral stuff as they did in the permanent or decaying stuff, in the case of all the rusting stuff. Yeah.
This little feather.
Yeah, and the beads. Get the beads.
Got the beads. And they threw in some actual flotsam, too.
Yeah.
Either that or they've been working on this so long, it's been here over a year, and it's been
yeah,
through a flood.
It hasn't accumulated over this wiring here.
That's right.
It would be on the outside if it was coming. Well, the river's the other direction, so it wouldn't be coming this way. It would come from the other side.
No, it would come in this way, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Because the tree trunks. Yeah,
yeah, because the river comes. Yeah, so I think it already has been through a flood.
Since last spring.
Yeah, it's been through a flood. Definitely not hurting anybody.
Amazing. Yeah, I'd say check with the university art department. See, who got their masters for this?
Yeah, look at, they got this. They got like a
chandelier. Yeah.
Somebody's old pieces of somebody's old Christmas tree.
Dolls. Look through here.
You got stuff in here, hey?
Yeah.
Dolls and ponies and whatever that is back in there.
You got a purple painted doll up here, kind of a freaky one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I can't see the eye too well. All the stuff in the way.
There's a bird nest somewhere in here.
Looks like it's upside down, or filled in with sand.
Yeah, it might have been filled in. Birds might have actually been nesting here, and when the flood came through, it might have filled in. I've seen that happen in trees before.
Okay. But it's solid. You take this.
Yeah.
Nothing's loose.
Yeah, this isn't a dangerous structure that's going to fall over. Someone could get tetanus on it or whatever, but...
Everything's
pretty solid. Yeah. Yeah, got some other. Who are these new kids on the block or something in here?
Hey, yeah, you got.
Just make a note that there's a guitar in here as well. Yeah, we're playing with different interpretations of this. One interpretation is that this is all the junk left down by the river by us that's washed around down by the river. That nobody takes care of, you know, the city doesn't do anything to go out and clean it up. But if somebody takes it and brings it all together in a structure like this that's interesting and draws our attention, then the city's going to come and rip it out. Then they'll take care of it. At big expense, I'm guessing. Yeah, people are crazy. All of that stuff in that structure was found down in here, obviously. And so it wasn't dangerous when it was all spread around on the river bottom. But because it was made into something, it's dangerous. And it's apparently more dangerous than anything else down here.